Hello everyone, and welcome to Memory Matters for All Ages. I'm Janelle Nichols from the Gables of Hudson Assisted Living Residence. This first week of the month, we usually talk about multitasking, and we're going to do the same thing today, but technology has brought multitasking to a whole new level, and sometimes a very frustrating level. With us today, as usual, is Catherine Kilpatrick, speech-language pathologist with over 40 years of experience, national speaker, author of over 30 publications. Kathy, have we lost our manners?
What do you observe as we...
I would say yes, very much so.
One of the things that I would like to encourage our viewers to do is to... take a look at the previous months, because we've talked about multitasking, the impact that it has on our memory. We also have talked about strategies, and we have also talked about some of the research. So I think that's something that people want to take a look at as well. And then today we are going to talk about that. And I think with the upcoming holidays, we really need to pay attention the younger population when we're spending time with older adults, because I am hearing from this population frustrations. You know, they're so excited to see their family. They don't get to see them very often, and it seems like everybody's looking down, working with something or watching a movie and so forth, and it's pretty, pretty frustrating. So that's why I kind of wanted us to put this in, and I think we talked about this, you know, to make some awareness for the holiday.
Well, I think it's a very important subject because we all face it. You cannot sit in a restaurant or any place without hearing phones going off, everyone looking down, and you're talking about older adults being frustrated. I get frustrated. My daughter is 31, and I get frustrated with her. That phone never leaves her hand. And of course, it's a wealth of information. I mean, it's a wonderful technology to have. It is. It's wonderful. But it is frustrating as far as conversation, time. I don't get to see her much. She doesn't live here in the area. So I'm very frustrated when I don't get to spend that time. I'm jealous of that time. But it is. Technology has taken us to a whole nother level.
Yeah, it really is. Yeah. And I think for those of us that have been around for a while, it's like, okay, you know, what goes on here. So why don't we talk about some things to think about. You need to make your own choices, what works for you, but I want you to just kind of contemplate some of these things and notice how the environment is changing. First of all, is it bad manners to constantly be checking for new messages when you're with someone? Just think about that. Another thing is, look at all the places where we are being reminded constantly to turn off our phones. Don't use it when you're going through the drive-through. You know, turn it off before you come into a certain office area. Over and over again, one gal who works at a fast food restaurant said, "You're not going to believe the rudeness. There was a customer coming through placing an order. In the middle of the order, she got a phone call, and so she asked the person taking her order, 'Would you please wait a minute while I take this call?'" She was like flabbergasted, even though it says there, no cell phones. And then you see it, you know, in the movie theaters. And then this was interesting. You know, you go shopping with a friend and you, you know, have a conversation. But then this gal calls all her friends on her lunch hour while she's driving around doing her errands. And that person feels somewhat cheated in all of that. So I think, you know, we've talked about kind of going to the balcony and noticing your behaviors. So what is it that you want to look like if someone, you know, was talking about this to you? I try to be real aware of it when I'm doing therapy, and because I don't want to disturb the session. And I'm careful if I take a call, it's only if I'm expecting from a doctor. And then I just make it as short as I possibly can, or if it's my office. But if I'm with a certain person or in a certain situation that's delicate, or I know that it would be very alarming to someone who doesn't even have a cell phone and, you know, have, you know, even the, not the rotary anymore, but, you know, that type of thing, and just not to do it at all, certainly not having the ringer on, and the one I have is a real tinkly little one, not one that just blasts some kind of music. So I think those are some things that we really need to pay attention to. So, you know, what is it that we need to do?
Well, I, I agree with you, and I've seen several of these same instances that you're talking about. But I think that one of our weaknesses to begin with is we're not good listeners. And we're not good listeners to begin with. And when our mind is already, if we're checking for messages, we're answering the phone when someone is waiting on us or helping us at a restaurant or a counter, we're not listening. That takes our listening completely to the dumper. Mm-hmm. And I think that's when mistakes happen. And it's also, I think it's disrespectful. Mm-hmm. For example, the lady, the example you gave, I'm at a fast food restaurant or giving an order, she takes a call, would you wait a minute? Well, what about the other people in line mm-hmm. behind you? Mm-hmm. It's rude. Right. I think in many respects we have lost our manners and our respect for each other and each other's time.
And I think that's key. Yeah. And everybody's so busy. It's a whole different story mm-hmm. if someone's got an emergency.
Absolutely.
You know, and now, then, and but we announced that.
I was going to tell you, I gave that. I was at the bank. Now, my mom is 90 years old, mm-hmm. and I am an only child. So when my mom, she very rarely calls my cell phone. When she calls, boy, you better believe I grab it no matter where I'm at. So I was at the bank, and that phone rang, and I glanced down at it, and it said, Mom. So I told the teller, I said, I've got to get this. This is my 90-year-old mom, and when she calls, it could be something. And I apologized, and she said, oh, she understood.
Right.
You know, so there are certain emergencies when we're going to grab that phone, mm-hmm. A teenager that's out, a mother, an emergency, a right. doctor.
Right.
All right.
But not the ongoing dialogue.
Absolutely, and not. If it can wait, it can wait.
Right. Right.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So how can you give us some more? We need more. I mean, what we're saying, I would think everybody watching is agreeing with mm-hmm. us, but how
oh,
do
maybe
we...
Oh, maybe not, though.
Well,
you know, I mean, we see a lot of people that's what their world has become, and we've talked about that in previous programs. What was it, one study that we did a little while, or read a while ago, 14 hours the student was spending mm-hmm. on his iPhone?
Right.
I mean... When do you
That's
have time
staggering.
To develop a personal yeah. relationship with mm-hmm. someone? I think, mm-hmm. you know, if you're spending more time with a device in a relationship than one-on-one contact, you know, how does that make you feel? And I think with the younger population, this is what they're used to doing. And recently I heard that, you know, even the younger, you know, younger than you and I. Let's go there.
Oh, thanks, Kathy.
Hey, I just had my 50th high school reunion, so don't worry about it, girl.
Thanks a lot.
They don't even email anymore. They want the little snippets, the little tweets mm-hmm. and the texting. So where's the conversation, you know, and how are we building that? So, and I think that it's hard. I remember a situation years ago where a friend of mine who's quite a bit younger spent most of the time that we were at a concert texting back and forth to her children. And she kind of had her back like this so that it wouldn't be disturbing. And I said nothing because I wanted to enjoy the concert, but I felt like she had a seat, but we weren't doing the experience that we've had with so many of the concerts that we've done. Mm-hmm. But I didn't want to say anything at that moment. And then weeks later, I said, what was going on? Because I kind of missed having my buddy there to talk about the concert. She says, well, we were trying to arrange rides for the kids for tomorrow for something. And I thought, you know, how did we handle that before mm-hmm. we had the capability of mm-hmm. doing that? So I think that's important.
Right.
And then, you know, suggesting, I really want to spend this time with you, so maybe you can put your phone on vibrate or do something like that. Or I think what I've done with a couple of friends is, why don't we have a mutual break to check our messages and everything, and then we can get back to doing what, you know, we're doing. So I think that's really, really important. Setting boundaries, I think, is one of the key things. And I'm hearing from more families as we talk about this with the holidays, is that they have a box or a basket, or they check the cell phones before someone comes in so mm. they can have the dinner together
sure.
and do that. And they, you know, and somebody had said to them, well, aren't you afraid they're not going to come around? And she said, I just have to teach them how I want to be treated. Mm-hmm. And that may be okay in their home, and I'm not in charge of any of those rules, mm-hmm. but for myself, that's, you know, really what's important. Mm-hmm. And we talked about the emergency, because I think that's very important, and I did exactly the same thing mm-hmm. when things were going on with my mom, even if I was in the middle of a therapy mm-hmm. session. And I was grateful for that, because otherwise, you know, when you have a break, you would go and call and check your answering machine at mm-hmm. home, and you couldn't be right on top of things mm-hmm. because of the kind of jobs that we have. So I think that's important. And then also just sharing when you're texting that, you know what, I'm checking with, you know, Mrs. Jones if this time or this time is going to be better for her, rather than just going on and on. Mm-hmm. You know, mm-hmm. so I think some of those things are key.
Yeah, I agree. And I think that the greatest thing that you can give to someone is your attention. Mm-hmm. It makes someone feel important, makes them feel that you are listening. I know it's interesting in our family. My husband gets frustrated if I get a text while we're together. I get frustrated. His phone never stops as a businessman. My mother gets aggravated if the phone rings when we're at dinner. Mm-hmm. That's a biggie. So there is a frustration. But I will share a funny thing I remembered while you were talking. Years ago, when Rudy Giuliani was running for president, he was getting ready to give a speech. I don't know if you'll remember this. Do you remember that, Kathy?
No, but it reminds me of another story.
His cell phone rang. He stopped the speech. He was just starting. And he pulled the cell phone out of his pocket. He said, oh, it's his wife. Excuse me. And he says, hey, honey. And she apparently said, what are you doing? He says, I'm getting ready to give a speech. All right. Love you, too. See you at home. Answered his cell phone in the middle. Maybe that's why he did not get the nomination. I don't know. That might be it. But, Kathy, what do you have for us to take with us this week? What can we remember?
I think, you know, you alluded to it. I have the relationship builder is being present with someone, being able to mm-hmm. have that time. Mm-hmm. And so this week, just once a day, twice a day, consider the situation that you're in, and then make a conscious choice, not an automatic pickup, mm-hmm. and, you know, not take that call. Think of what it's going to do to the situation that you're in, and how important that person is and that connection. I mean, mm-hmm. when someone told me one day that their boss was behind someone who's sitting there texting to somebody at home while the boss is trying to get their attention, and mm-hmm. it was like, I mean, is this the way it is? Yeah. Or do we, you know, so.
Yeah. All right. Well, those are very, very good thoughts. And I think it's a very pertinent subject because we see it,
yeah.
a lot of
Absolutely.
Discussion. We see it wherever we go. There are signs up, like you said, even in the fast food restaurants now, there are signs, please mm-hmm. no cell phones while you're in line. So it is a very important subject, and I think that we're all experiencing it. And even when you mention the theater, you'll see people will cheat with that about halfway through. If they get bored, you can see the light in that dark theater from their phone mm-hmm. that shows.
Have you been in a theater where someone's been escorted out? I have.
Have you?
Yes.
Really?
Yes.
I have not
yes.
yet.
Someone complained and they
yet.
Escorted them
yes.
out.
Yes. yes.
And
well,
we need to learn with it, mm-hmm. and it's going to be an ongoing thing. And yeah. I have a little quote to end with,
Wonderful.
Which I think is very appropriate.
I love your quotes.
Yeah, it's fun searching for them. Mm-hmm. It's like, I got to find just the right one. Mm-hmm. Good manners are just a way of showing other people that we have respect for them, by Bill Kelly.
That is perfect, because I think a lot of this boils down to respect, not just respect for your family, but respect for everybody. Mm-hmm. The teller at the bank, the person at McDonald's, respect mm-hmm. is the mm-hmm. key. That's an excellent quote. Mm-hmm. I really like that. Well, I hope today gave you some pause for thought. It has me. Mm-hmm. Kathy, thank you so much.
Oh, thank you.
We'll be back next week with some more good information. At the end of this broadcast, please watch, and you'll see information about Kathy's blog and how to contact her and her websites. There'll be further information on there about what we talked about today. You'll also be able to contact us. We're talking about doing a show where we answer some of your questions and your emails to us. You can contact Kathy there. Thank you very much for joining us today. Now go and make it a great day.